It's time for another Windows upgrade. Last year, I made a video about restoring the original software that this HP laptop from early 2015 came with, Windows 8.1 Home Edition. I was supposed to get rid of that OS installation because it was just a test for that video. But morbid curiosity got the best of me this time, so I kept it. I don't use this computer much anymore, and I wanted to see what would happen when Windows 8 support ended in January 2023. That month seemed so far ahead back then, but it's past now, and all this computer got was a full screen notice, similar to the Windows 7 one 3 years ago. Now there is absolutely no excuse to keep this OS. While Windows 10 is by no means flawless, I have to appreciate that Microsoft backtracked on their awful UI design choices, at least a little bit, while keeping the same system requirements. 10 still has a tablet mode for people who prefer the full screen start menu and gestures. So 8 really has no advantages over it. Some people say Windows 8 had great performance, but in my testing over the years on various computers, it never performed better than both 7 and 10, although your mileage may vary. Even if Windows 8 was faster, I still wouldn't want to keep it. And yes, the upgrade to Windows 10 is still free, even though Microsoft would rather you buy a whole new computer instead. But computers that came with Windows 8 are far from obsolete, even if they're upwards of 10 years old. And may still have a lot of life left. So let's try the free upgrade again. It takes some time to download and install, but it's easy and requires little user input. You can do other stuff while waiting, as I did. This laptop has a 4th gen Core i7, 4GB of RAM, and 240GB SATA SSD. It will be slower if you don't have an SSD, but you only have to do it once. It used to have 8GB of RAM, but I downgraded it to 4 to upgrade a different computer. For the basics, 4GB of memory are still enough. I wasn't there when the upgrade finished, so I don't know how long it took exactly. But I think it was around half an hour. And after setting it up, it's more or less the same look as before. It's using the light theme, but it can be changed. Besides that HP documentation software, which is not vital, everything is there working as normal. And now Edge can be upgraded to the newest version. I haven't tested it a lot, but so far haven't run into any issues, not even minor ones. I just had to update HP Support Assistant manually. Unlike Windows 7 computers, which are older, and can sometimes have problems upgrading to 10, even though they usually work okay, Windows 8 and 10 are almost the same under the hood, so the upgrade is even safer, even though you should always have a backup, of course. In the past, I've had Windows 10 running on this computer for years perfectly, but that was a clean installation. You can do a clean installation of Windows 10 on a Windows 7 or 8 computer. If it asks for a product key, you can enter your computer's Windows 7 or 8 one. But I wanted to see how the upgrade worked. If some drivers are missing or outdated, you can update them with Windows Update or with Snappy Driver Installer. And bloatware can be uninstalled manually. I've decided to set up this laptop in the living room, always plugged in with the battery removed, connected to the television with the HDMI, and controlling it with a wireless keyboard and mouse, so it can be used for web browsing with Edge or Firefox, or watching DVDs with VLC Media Player. It works perfectly. And there we have it. I'm sure even after Windows 10 support ends in October 2025, these computers will still be useful for basic computing tasks. And they can stay secure online with a new Linux distribution, although they require much more tinkering compared to an official Windows upgrade, but it is what it is. Thank you for watching.